Chapter 7, Ethereal Requiem. Una says, "By the way..." "What is it?" asks Forte. "Why did Grandpa Mac remain in Burradine? He was saying such things, but if there's a person who wants to see Leon most, it's Grandpa Mac." "Everybody has his or her role to play," says Forte. "Grandpa must have a plan, and also..." "Also what?" "He wants to see Leon when he has time to chat with him over a drink or something. He can't do it in this time of crisis." "Oh really? Betting that he really is still alive." "I bet he is, actually." Thomas says, "Well, I must go and concentrate on steering the ship. We're in uncharted territory. We can't be too careful." "Taking the whole ship to another world? Lap's proposal is outrageous, to say the least." Mitchell says, "We're racing against time. We can't make it without a ship." Avon says, "That means we must travel at sea." "No kidding." "Yes, there will be sea and mountains," says Mitchell. "It's the world created by the spirits and notions of mankind. We should find everything we have in this world. Of course, things may not look exactly the same as they do here." "Yeah, I hope not. I hope it looks crazy." "Whatever another world may be, we must find the last resonance stone by any means," says Forte. "The water melody will be complete only when we have all the resonance stones. If there's even the slightest chance, we must keep our hopes high and do our best." "I remember," says Avon. "Once I was as passionate about something as Forte is now." "Yes, to find his sister Emel." "How's Emel, anyway?" "Doing. Troubles may await us, but we never know unless we try. Forte, don't ever give up." "Let's go," says Thomas. "Captain, a ship is approaching us from 3 o'clock. "What?" "Whoa. I haven't been allowed to save the game. It's Ramon," says Thomas. "Please don't bother us. We're in a hurry." Oh, this is jerks again. "Stop! Captain Thomas!" yells Ramon. "What is it, Ramon? Speak quickly!" "You know Rish? He says that he'll give us a lot of money if we get his revenge against you for destroying the plans he had with Numeros." "Don't feel bad about this." "Yeah, I'll show you," says Rish. "What the heck are you saying at a time like this?" says Avon. "Captain, we have no time," says Mitchell. "Yeah, leave it to me," says Thomas. What? Says Ramon. "You're not supposed to jump across over here." Was he breaking the rules of engagement or something? "Don't you know that we're supposed to tell our names to each other, then shoot cannons at each other?" Okay, yeah, he is breaking the rules of engagement. "And then move on to melee combat? And you're alone. Are you underestimating me?" "Can't you see that thing over there?" says Thomas. Thomas pointed at the dark sun emitting a strange aura high above Wrecked Island. "Show us. I want to see it." "Of course I can see it. So what?" "That's not what I meant." "Man, they're having a nice conversation over there," says Mile. "We really don't have time for this," Forte says. "Ramon, what do you like to do?" says Thomas. "Of course. I like to hunt treasure and attack ships." "Rish, what about you?" says Thomas. "I like to make money, of course." "Now, listen, you two. If the Dark Sun explodes, this world will be gone. What happens if this world is gone?" "You won't have anyone you can fool to rob them blind, and you won't have any ships to attack." What? "That's not good," says Rish. "Well, these people are really... cannot connect the dots." "Then who can I take money from?" "We won't have any boats to attack," says Ramon. "Well, you won't even be alive, so there's that." "That's not good." "See, that's not good at all," says Thomas. "I agree," says Rish. Yeah, says Ramon. If you understand, help us out, says Thomas. Mumble, mumble. Oh, he's mumbling something to Rish. Now he's going mumble, mumble to Ramon. Okay, you can count on us, says Rish. We'll show you the power of pirate networking, Ramon says. Okay, I'm counting on you, says Thomas. What were you talking to Ramon and Rish about? Asked Forte. Oh, I asked them to find someone for me. Let's go! Hurry! I had something I wanted to talk to Lap about. Who do we want to find? Leon? I heard that there was another person in Shulf besides Arya who could use their technique. That was about 10 years or so ago. If we can find him, he could be of help. And since we don't have time, I asked Ramon to look for him. I wonder who it could be. Someone from Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, maybe? I don't even remember the characters' names, and isn't that horrible? Another person? Hazuna? Really? Mitchell says, now, we don't have much time. If we miss this chance, we'll be stuck here for another day. Okay, let's go, says Thomas. Ramon and Rish, after their discussion with Thomas, retreated peacefully, and the pirate ship went somewhere. And the window of time for entering another world is the 12 seconds from the beginning of the warp at Wrecked Island to the time it ends. The beginning of the warp at Wrecked Island. Thomas held the controls to the Planetos II once again. Oh, there's the flashing phenomenon that we saw from afar. Ruka, sail forward at full speed! I'm doing it! Space is starting to warp, says Mitchell. We only have a small window of time. Captain Thomas, at this speed... We won't make it? Says Thomas. Damn, survival of the world is on our shoulders. Captain, says Ruka. Tell everyone on the deck to hold on to something. What are you doing? Says Thomas. I'll increase the engine output to the maximum. Will we be okay? We don't want to get to another world and find the engine broken, says Thomas. If it's broken, I'll fix it. The warp in space will last for 12 seconds, says Mitchell. 11 seconds? It's our only option, says Thomas. Ruka, go for it. Everyone, hang on to something to keep yourself from being shaken off the ship. Aye, aye, sir. Everyone on ship says. I think that's been 12 seconds. Too late. I mean, he had to run down there first and everything. We'll be counting on you, Ruka. Hang in there, Planetos 2. And I assume that was him at the engine. We're entering the warp in space, says Mitchell. Must have yelled down to have someone else do it. This is a very long cutscene. Una says, are we there? This is another world, says Forte. Una, look. What's that, says Thomas. Oh, is that the dark sun? What's another dark sun, right? Is this the same as the dark sun in our world? Except it hasn't been fed any negative notions. Avon says, is that? No, it can't be. The wave. Yes, I think it is, says Mitchell. Oh yeah, the wave of Rao y'all, whatever. The dark sun from another world. It's the sphere filled with harmful frequencies that the water tribe transferred 950 years ago. That? Says Forte. It's several times bigger than the dark sun from our world. And it looks different, too. This one's more creepy, says Evan. Mitchell says, compared to the one in Weltluna, this one seems like it's in the final stages. You mean, it's growing, says Una? Wasn't it not supposed to grow in another world? Why? Says Forte. Mitchell says, I don't know why, but that size, it's well past the maximum capacity if it were in our world. It probably lasted this long because this world didn't have any negative notions to begin with. This isn't good. We need to be careful. Forte says, even if we enter any battles here, it's probably better if we don't use any resonant spells. Can I still use the healing one? I might just, depend on Miles' healing. And, Jan and Rick. I agree, says Mitchell. Maybe not all of them, but the offensive resonant spells may affect that thing. Okay, indicating that the healing spells might be okay. I'm sorry, but please understand. We don't know what might happen, says Una. Yes, we still don't know the details, says Mitchell, but we do know that we're under dangerous circumstances. We need to be careful. Avon says, Forte, Una, let us take care of the spells. Forte and Una, let's take care of the spells. Okay. We also have Mitchell, so if you need any spells, we'll support you, says Mile. Okay, thanks, says Forte. Thomas says, now let's start on our journey in this world to find a last resonance stone. Mitchell says, the descendants of the water tribe that moved here must be around. How are we going to find them? Asks Forte. We don't even have a map of this world. We need to find a place where we can get onto land, says Thomas. Keep your eyes open for a light from a harbor or something. The light bulb, ding! Forte has an idea. He says, Thomas, it looks like lights of a village over there. Really? It looks like the people did move here to live, says Una. The descendants of the water tribe that left Weltluna. Yeah, let's get closer, says Thomas. Thomas skillfully steered the ship and got the Planetos II close to the shore. A prout? That's the name of this village. Okay, we're about to set foot in another world, says Thomas. We have no idea what lies ahead. Be on your toes. I want to go with you, but if something goes wrong with the ship, it'll affect our operation. We'll take the safe approach and stay here. Don't worry about us. Go do your work on land. Okay, so we got Forte, Mitchell, Una, Jan and Rick, Avon and Mile. Awesome. Okay. We're all level 37 except for Jan and Rick. We're 36. Doesn't tell us, like... I don't know if it ever says... I don't think we can tell how close we are to the next level until we're in the finishing battle screen. Yeah, okay. Alright, so we'll go talk to people in here. And... can we just... We'll see if we can buy anything else downstairs. Subleader Ruka was a blast furnace engineer when he was a child. He is still young, but he has sound knowledge and skills. The modified HF6 engine, which is the second motive power of this ship, is also the result of his experience with blast furnaces. He still conducts research whenever he has time. I take my hat off to his devotion. Nope, you lie. Your hat did not move. Man, all oceans are the same. As long as you're on this boat, we'll guarantee your safety. Just concentrate on your work. All oceans are the same. This one looks very blue, though. Very bright blue. Alright, let's go below decks. Get back here. It seems like the oceans here aren't too different from the oceans of our world, but it could be different on land. Be careful, okay? Okay, okay. Don't follow us. It's creeping. Let's buy more of these things. Actually, well, let's go here after. Oh, there's a chest here. Was this chest here before? Orb of Ocean 33. 53. 33 and 53. And 83. All these Orb of Oceans. 33, 53, and 83. Image of Mitchell. Sirius Thomas. Image of Ruka. Okay. Oh. Dark out. Is it dark out before? That's the weapon shoppy. Should talk to Ruka. Let us in. The damage isn't as major as we thought, so we should be able to fix it. It may take some time, though. I'll have it fixed by the time we leave. Okay. Alright, let's do the exchange. So, just over 13,000 gents. Alright, let's sell these, gems. Ruby? Selling it for 1,000. Cat's Eye? Selling that for 500. And Emerald? Two of them, selling for, I guess, 800 each. Awesome, now we have 15,301. Okay, no one needs a moon. A veteran sword? Oh, brother. Alright, so veteran sword is long sword integrated with arm guard. Hard to use, but produces deadly force. Spin saucer from Mile. Boomerang shaped like a curved triangle. Spins fast, so it looks like a saucer. Hmm. Ash rod for Mitchell. Rod made of charmed ash, favored by sorcerers. Ash bow for Una. Bow made of ash. Three thin plates are laminated for added power. We have charged shields. Shield of blocking. We need some of those. Soldier armor. For Forte and Una. Maybe Mitchell. Brother. It's getting insane over here. Well, who's my party gonna be? Avon, Mile, Forte, and Una? Okay. Forte, Jan and Rick, Avon and Mile. Okay. Yeah, we can buy all that. Shield of blocking. Forte, Avon, Mile. Alright, we're buying three of these. Actually, we have another thing we can sell. Who has the warrior fur? I guess, McBain dropped it? Or Thomas dropped? I don't know. So, shield of blocking is shield formed in a maple leaf shape. Catches a blade with a concave tip. Alright, well let's... upgrading from the charge shield to shield of blocking. It's only defense, two more. But we'll take it. I'm gonna sell all this extra stuff. We need money. No one needs a warrior fur, right? We all have that. Charge shield. Five of them. 2750 gents. Alright, we're back to where we were. Let me just see. Yeah, Jan and Rick can't wear that. Soldier armor. What's better? Warrior? I guess warrior fur is better? Although soldier armor is better. So some of us have that. I'm just buying one right now for Forte. This is like a major upgrade for everybody, or almost everybody. Soldier armor, so defense going up by 7 points. Now Mitchell still has the warrior fur and so does Una, but I'm not going to have them in the main party that much, or at all. So I'm going to wait on them, wait on that. So let's sell 3 warrior furs for 6,300 gents. That's pretty good. We're gaining in money. The wire glove is 2,700. I don't know if I want to go back to the wire glove. Just he pushes them so far away. Let me just look at that. Oh, that's right. He's not with us. I'm looking for McBain to see, like, how far down he goes back. If we get, yeah. So let's sell it anyway. Wire glove for 2,700. We have Knight Sword. Yeah, the Moon Sword is better. Okay, let's sell the Knight Sword. Being very careful here, I don't want to sell anything and then have to buy it back for an obscene amount of money. Wow, we almost 20,000 gents right now. High Chakram, that's miles. Okay, we'll sell that too. Gents. Wow. We have almost 23,000 gens. Never had this much money. We're rich! Okay, so no one needs a moon sword. We need veteran swords. 8,000 each. And then 10,000 for the spin saucer. Oof. Ashrod are gonna wait. Mitchell's on the sidelines. Una's on the sidelines. Shield of blocking, we all have. Soldier armor. Okay. Alright, let's get these two veteran swords then. Destroying our funds here. Alright, veteran sword. Attack going up by 12 points. Nice. Better be worth it. And same here, 12 points. Alright, let's sell these moon swords and see how much we have left. 6,000. I still have almost 13,000. Veteran swords. Alright, so we need the spin saucer for Mile. And if anything left, we'll get something for our party members who are off on the sidelines. Probably Una, because I might switch her in now and then. Not sure how useful Mitchell is, really. Alright, spin saucer, 10,000 gents. Oof. It's like, are you sure? Yeah, I'm sure. Alright, Mile. Only the best for Mile. Spin saucer. Alright, he's also going up by 12 points in attack. That's significant. So we'll sell the High Galer for 4,000. Let's see, can we afford anything else? Not the ash rod for Mitchell. Almost, but not the ash bow for Una. A couple battles and we might be able to have enough to buy that for her. Get her the soldier armor, actually. Best offense is a good defense. Okay. Whoops. Oh, I'm in magic. What am I doing there? Right, warrior fur. Now soldier armor. Increasing by 7 points defense. Right, selling warrior fur. 4,000. Let's see something. Let's unequip this. I want to see how much we can sell it for. We have 4,051, and if we sell... How much is it? Hold on 1 second. It's 6,000. Fairy bow we can sell for 3,000. Okay, good. So with it, her attack is 237. Yeah, I'm not going to remember these numbers. Alright. Attack 347. Defense 194. Because I want to compare. I'm not going to be able to because we're going to sell this. Selling. And now buying... the fairy bow for 6,000. I mean, no, the ash bow. The fairy bow is the one we just sold. Okay. Actually, we can compare this way. Okay, so attack is going up by 13 points and defense by 1. Oh, wait, we don't have enough. Why did I think we would have enough? I was looking at this. I was looking at the wrong one. If we can sell enough things, obviously I'm gonna get selling this. I never use these books. I mean, what are these? Really? I never use them because I don't know what they do. Well, we need a tiny bit of money. I mean, maybe we can just get some money? I wish we could sell, like, the books and stuff. Well, she doesn't have a bow now. That stinks. Well, we gotta get her that. I forget how many roses equal a gent. But like one rose equals more than one gent, something like that. Anyway, I hope to adventure a little bit and then just come right back here. I'll wait till we have a certain amount of roses and then we'll come back. If we can. Otherwise I'll really be keeping her on the sidelines because she won't have a weapon to use. Anyway, I'm going to call it an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.